We would like to welcome everyone to the Special Design Review Committee called meeting, February the 20th. I am serving as the chair in place of Jim Roberts, who is our chair, and I'm the vice chair. The DRC is a subcommittee of the Historic Zoning Commission. We work with the applicants at their request to look at projects before they go before the official design review process with the Historic Zoning Commission. So this is more casual. Anything that's said is not binding or is not an official vote. So with that, we will turn it over to Ms. Kelly Danzenfelser.
Thank you. Thanks for being here today. We are really excited to show you the preliminary elevations for the new City Hall building. Our consultant team has been working really hard on this project, on the scale, the context, the form, the materials, a building that can really stand the test of time on our historic public square. So Anna Ruth is going to give a presentation. It's about 10 to 15 minutes. And then we are really looking forward to hearing your feedback and discussion about the building elevations as we move forward in this project. So Anna Ruth, thank you.
Anna Ruth, would you kind of identify who you are for our listeners?
Yes, my name is Anna Ruth Kimbrough. I'm an architect with Studio 8 Design. Our architectural partners for the project are OHM. Gary Seaball is here with us today. And I'm the project manager for the City Hall project. So thank you for taking the time for this special meeting to review the 25% schematic design progress for Franklin City Hall. We gained some very constructive feedback in our last meeting with you, and we are really anxious to share these initial elevation studies with you in the following slides. So today we'll be sharing our initial design for the square elevations and the Third Avenue elevation. We have 3D perspective views and 2D elevations within the context to help explain the proposed design. We'd like to gain your feedback on these initial elevation studies, particularly on building materiality, fenestration, scale and rhythm, architectural detailing, and a water element that we're proposing in the plaza on the square. At the end, we would also like to share an elevation of the potential retail that BOMA would like us to consider, and we are going to be discussing this with BOMA at the February 28th BOMA work session. So as a reminder of the discussion in our previous meeting, we wanted to reshare this precedent imagery slide since these images garnered a lot of valuable feedback from your committee at the last meeting. We took all your feedback from the last meeting into consideration as we started to develop the elevations. So the high-level bullet points from that feedback are on this slide. There was consensus around the preference for the broken-up massing of the New York City neighborhood courthouse. The new City Hall design should speak to the sense of place of Franklin. You felt that the proposed 2009 City Hall design could be anywhere and did not speak to the sense of place of historic downtown Franklin. The commissioners liked the materiality and rhythm of the Birmingham City Hall, particularly the rhythm of the openings, the pilaster, the use of brick and stone accents. And then we also discussed the appropriate use of historic precedents within the proposed design of City Hall. In relation to the livery stable arches that we had a photo on this slide previously, and then in reference to the new Clarksville City Hall as compared to the historic City Hall that Susan Besser brought forward. So on this slide, you'll see an updated site plan from the one you saw at the last meeting. This site plan shows the potential retail on the site that we'll be discussing with BOMA on February 28th. We are proposed, well, as a reminder, hang on, let me see if my cursor, sorry. As a reminder, the footprint of City Hall, can you see my cursor? Okay. The footprint of City Hall is here. The potential retail that we'll be discussing with BOMA is here. We're proposing a park at the south end of the site along Church Street. And then we have a restroom building that goes along with the potential retail that, again, will be decided upon in our meeting with BOMA. As a reminder, we were proposing a raised plaza here on the corner of the square and 3rd Avenue. It'll wrap around the corner of the building to 3rd, and we're proposing a water element here on the corner of that plaza. A water feature is something that enhances an experience in a public place, so we would like to incorporate the sound of water into the plaza. We are proposing to widen this pedestrian promenade to the existing 2nd Avenue parking deck and enhance the pedestrian experience along this promenade and along the alley behind the building. We are proposing a courtyard here in line with the pedestrian connector behind the county courthouse, which helps to break up the scale and massing of the building along 3rd Avenue, as you'll see in the upcoming perspective views. So on the following slides, what we've done is we've included a photo of the existing context that's taken from the same perspective as the proposed perspective views of the initial design. So this is a view of the existing City Hall from the corner of Public Square and 3rd Avenue South. Here's the proposed design from the same perspective view. The front wall, as a reminder of the front wall of the proposed design, will align with the front wall of the courthouse, completing the geometry of this quadrant of the square. The raised plaza is here that we just saw in the site plan, with the proposed water element here in the foreground in the corner of the plaza. As you can see, the proposed design is predominantly brick with a stone cornice line at the top of the second floor level. The reason for the placement of this stone cornice line is a strategy to help make the third floor feel recessed and make the eye stop at the top of the second floor level. We're proposing these two flanking portico elements and exploring the idea of ceremonial rooftop terraces that overlook the square and 3rd Avenue. The proportions of the windows relate proportionally to the courthouse, which you'll see on the following slides. We heard in the last meeting that the design of the corner of the building is very important. So we are proposing these flanking portico elements to really offset the corner of the proposed design. And then further down 3rd Avenue, you can see there's the courtyard here, which is the break in the building that aligns with that pedestrian connector behind the county courthouse. And then the building steps down to a two-story height that relates better to the residential and civic buildings further down 3rd Avenue South. So this is another view that we're going to look at of the proposed design. This is further back on the square at the vehicular entrance from Main Street into the square, and it's the view of the existing City Hall building, and then the same perspective view of the proposed design. This view allows you to see the design from further back than the previous view. You can see that the height of the building is about the height of the midpoint of the courthouse roof, as we discussed. The flanking portico elements, again, accentuate the corner of the building. You can see also in this view how the massing of the building is broken up down 3rd Avenue in the break in the elevation with the courtyard. The top of the parapet wall, we're proposing a brick corbelling detail instead of a stone cornice as another strategy to help the third floor be less prominent and allow the stone cornice to remain the main horizontal datum of the building. And then this is the view from across the square. It's really hard to get a picture of this quadrant of the square, not in shadow, but this is the existing city hall there. And then our proposed design of the city hall. You can see the 231 building on the left and the historic courthouse on the right. This view gives you a better idea of the scale and proportion of the windows as they relate to the scale and proportion of the windows of the courthouse. This also shows the portion of the city hall elevation that is perceived from this viewpoint, and the rest of the elevation is hidden by the 231 building. Let's see. And then the rest of we're going to see the rest of the elevation of this building and the 2D elevations in the upcoming slides, since the 231 building hides it in this view. So here's the 2D elevations. We wanted to include these along with the perspective views to give you an idea of what it looks like in the context. So again, this is the entry elevations of City Hall facing the square. The top one is the full elevation of the City Hall as proposed, and it includes the elevation along the pedestrian connector to the Second Avenue parking garage shown over here. So you can see the courthouse on the right and the parking garage on the left, and the relationship of the building to both those contextual buildings. And then on the bottom is, again, similar to that perspective view. It's the portion of the elevation that is perceived from across the square. And we want to point out the intentional alignment of the cornice line above at the top of the second floor with the cornice line of the Mellow Mushroom building. And the continuation of this cornice line helps in the cohesiveness of these two quadrants of the square. And then this is the proposed Third Avenue elevation. Again, the portico element is here in the center, and it's centered on the boardroom plan, and it helps provide shade for the double height windows that are going to be proposed in the boardroom. And then you can see the courtyard here that's in line with that pedestrian connector, and the recessed third floor of City Hall. And this is about 100 feet back from the face of the building, and it serves as the third floor's connection to the service elevator and to an egress stair. And then the building, as we mentioned previously, steps down to two levels, and we have the IT department on the first floor and the fire department on the second floor. This elevation does not include the retail elevation that we will be looking at with BOMA on the 28th. So on the next elevation, this is the same one you saw on the previous slide with the addition of the proposed retail at the end. We wanted to share this elevation with you to get your feedback before we go and discuss this with BOMA on the 28th to get your thoughts on that. And again, if it's decided that we do not go forward with the retail, the park just becomes larger on the south end of the site. So that concludes the elevation overview of the square and Third Avenue elevations. Again, we would love to get your feedback on anything really, but particularly on building materiality, fenestration, scale and rhythm, architectural detailing, the watermill element in the plaza, and then the potential retail. So thank you for your time, and we'd love to hear your comments.
Thank you. It's turned on. Yeah. What, am I not up close enough, maybe? Okay. What we've generally been doing is just going commissioner by commissioner, if everybody's comfortable with that. You want to start with your comments, Scott?
I'll start with that. I thought you'll start with that.
Well, they always do start there, so I decided we would.
Very nicely done. I do like the layout overall. One of the questions that pops up to me is the retail going to have above, is it going to work above, they'll work a little above retail, or is it going to be two-story retail?
We're proposing to build it two stories in height, which will be open both floors for the retail, since a higher floor is,
okay,
you want that for retail, but we're going to design it so that we can add a second floor for City Hall expansion in the future. So the retail is intended for expansion at the end.
Okay, so it'll basically just be a two-story atrium. looks good. I think it fits in well with synergy for the rest of the existing buildings on the square.
My turn?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Lisa.
So, just objectively, on its own, very elegant, very beautiful, kind of magnificent to a certain degree. And I would say that the public square elevation, I don't see how the terraces. I don't see how the terraces are consistent with anything within the context of that building. So they stand out as an inconsistent feature with the rest of the public square. I think to a certain degree, it's also distracting from the courthouse, which we want to be the main character here. And you have the pillars, like the courthouse. They seem a little bit, I wouldn't use the term copycat, but we don't like for new buildings to copy what's on the old buildings. You have four pillars on the old, four on the new. And I know they're square columns, but still, from afar, it looks a little bit too similar from my mind. The other thing that seems inconsistent is those massive windows, the three massive windows. There's nothing that I can identify, could be wrong, that approximates that much mass when it comes to a window. Now, on the Third Avenue view, I think for that view, there's a little more flexibility. So perhaps the terrace from there with the windows and all that may not be as eye-catching or distracting from the rest of the square. And in terms of the water feature on the corner, to me, that doesn't, I mean, unless you had something specific in terms of what that water feature would entail, I'm not sure it reflects, quote, the sense of place that you were referring to. One second. And then the retail, that also seems inconsistent with that particular area of the city. The building itself seems consistent in how it looks, but the use as a retail would be inconsistent and out of context. That would be my input.
My turn.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot to absorb here.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I'll start on the public square facing elevation. And really, it's a comment on all the elevations we have. I see you beginning to break down kind of the scale, this three-story, and it's a lot of mass to, you know, dress up the best you can. I don't know that it may be just not far enough along, and it might be that this is the intention, but I think that third level that is supposed to be kind of taking a back seat to kind of this two level, it feels just as heavy to me as the base sections do. Oftentimes that is just mitigated with some different brick detailing, whether it's different or more glass or just something a little lighter as it touches the sky is often the mechanism used. I think it could be helpful in this situation, even if you do end up with the same brick body up there. If it's detailed differently, in terms of how that cornice works. And obviously it's a different cornice, but the pilasters, the window openings, do they have limestone lintels on the first floor and not the third? Just something that dissinuates the weight between the bottom and the top, I think would help me feel like it's getting lighter as it goes up, which I think would be perceived that way. I kind of wrestle with the two porticos a little bit, because to me it says, well, which one's the way in? Just from somebody that doesn't live here, doesn't come mm-hmm. down here, hasn't been to City Hall, is like, is it that one? Is it this one? I think there's ways to address that too. I'm not against two porticos, but as long as a really intentional effort's put towards really saying this is the front, I think it can be a little confusing to have a porch that has no entry. It's just a weird concept in my mind. If it's just windows, maybe it's done differently. What else did I write down? That's all I have for now. I may think of something else.
So I want to start basically just asking a few questions about the concept. So what we were first hearing about was, like, you know, a building that might have some arches and things like that downtown. So what we're presented here is something, it's a different idea. And I'd like to hear how that idea may have developed and kind of, you know, what, where that comes from and where you're going with that.
We did study arches in the elevations and studied them with the city team. We had a celebratory arch at the entrance and at the boardroom as kind of a celebration of the corner. We felt that it again diminished the courthouse and became too prominent and too celebratory and competed with the arch diagonally across the square as well. And there are many arches along Main Street, and so we just felt like the rectangular openings were more appropriate here. And then the glass here at the entry, what we were trying to do with this portico is to celebrate the entry. It is a double height lobby, so the exterior is speaking about what's going on inside. So the windows up top are actually almost the exact size of the window, proportional to the windows of the courthouse. So they're not different in size or scale of the windows of the courthouse. The ones that are at the entrance, they might seem different. And then we were going to put some kind of panel in between the windows and the doors. So we wanted to denote entry and have a welcoming, transparent lobby, because it is a city hall. We don't want it to feel too imposing to people on the square. The portico on the boardroom side, we will have the sills of the windows up high, so you won't be able to go in, but I definitely hear your concern about the portico element. So to answer your question about the arches, we just felt like it was forced, and we heard in our last meeting that, you know, trying to force the arch or talking about the livery stables. I will say the courtyard is kind of our nod to the livery stables with that notch in the building, but we didn't make it a literal arch.
So you're actually drawing in some of the courthouse elements mm-hmm. over to here.
Proportions, so, yeah, since they're on the same, like, elevation, and they're quadrants that are visible to each other. So yes, we are drawing the proportions of the windows.
I think the mass and scale, I mean, you know, they are appropriate, I think, to the corner. Mm-hmm. Something that just really draws my eye is that stone cornice.
Mm-hmm.
And it kind of truncates that building. It, you know, it just divides it horizontally.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I don't have any, there's no problem that I personally have with our city hall having mass and three stories in height without trying to mask that third story.
Mm-hmm.
And I think maybe if that cornice were moved up, you know, to the top of the building, you know, that might help. It might not be drawn to the middle of the building,
right,
and see the entire facade as one facade.
Okay.
I think the porticos on each side, I mean, I think that's a nice, whether you're coming down Third Avenue or you're on the square, you know, you see the city hall, almost like a side porch that you would mm-hmm. have, you know, on a Greek Revival type structure. The columns being square, can you kind of talk to me about the, you know, the concept to make for them to be square rather than a round column?
really, we just felt like the style of the building was so civic and presence. And again, we didn't want to completely mimic the courthouse with the tapered columns. We try to keep odd number of bays, just traditional architecture. We don't want to have four or six bays or two bays. So we did do three bays because it just fits with the proportion and scale of the front, and just felt like the square columns would give it, you know, distinguish it from the courthouse, but also give it that civic presence.
And I understand. I think that's a good way to go. Mm-hmm. The square just kind of looks very massive to me when you first mm-hmm. look at it. And I'm wondering, so the ones at the courthouse are actually cast iron and they're fluted. Right. And I wonder if these were round and cast stone or some kind of look like that, that would still distinguish it from the cast iron fluted columns, mm-hmm. but make soften that heavy look.
Okay.
The other thing I would, so the way the lights are in the fenestration. Mm-hmm. So I noticed a lot of these are either 2/2, oh, I guess, well, it's 4/4 is what you would see, or 8/8.
Right.
And is that because on the courthouse on the front, they're 8/8? Mm-hmm. Did you ever examine any of the old pictures of the courthouse?
I've seen some, yes.
The earliest photograph, I think, that we have of the original courthouse was 1889. Mm-hmm. And the windows are very unique. They have a large mullion in the center, and then they have 6/6 mm-hmm. from muntins of smaller windows. In 1936 or 37, they did a remodel. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm going to call it, more than a remodel. And the windows are awful on that one. In the 1970s, they put those 8/8 in.
Okay.
So I'm wondering where that 8/8 came from with them, you know, how they decided on 8/8.
Right.
You know, traditionally, like you're talking about the three bays, mm-hmm. you're getting that odd number or something divisible by three. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you get a 6/6 or a 9/9 or a 12/12. To me, proportionally, that would be more aesthetically pleasing mm-hmm. in a classical form. And for the windows that are in the bay that, you know, that are, I believe there are, how much did I count there? 20 lights. If you were to look at what they originally did on the courthouse windows and repeat those in those spots, that might make an architectural stylistic change that you're looking for mm-hmm. and also pay homage to this, to what the courthouse originally had.
Okay.
And I would say on the transom, so actually above the entrance doors, it looks like a transom.
Yes.
Which is, and a divided transom like on the courthouse. But over on the far left, I think it looks like solid transom windows.
Oh, I know what you're talking, these right here. The
looking for your cursor.
Right here.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering, you know, if it wouldn't be more, you know, consistent for those to have lights too.
Okay.
And as far as the water feature, that, you know, I can't say that I am opposed to a water feature, as long as we don't say that it actually is where the old city water trough was.
And we are not doing that.
Okay, you're good. I'm open-minded to the water trough. I mean, the water feature. And that concludes my comments.
Okay, thank you very much.
Ready for me? Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. I won't pile on to everything. I mean, I just think y'all did a really nice job. One thing that stands out to me are the squared off columns, mm-hmm. and that just, it reminds me of a little town in Kentucky where they came in and put in a new civic building many, many years later. And it just, for some reason, that grabs my eye in a way that I think detracts from everything else that you've done.
Okay.
And I don't know why, other than I do think it reads a little heavier and it just reads a little more modern, which maybe that's what we should be doing. But I think for the feel and scale of the square, that to me jumps out as a detraction. The water feature, the only concern I have is all this, when you look at the renderings, reads bigger than I think it feels in real life. Mm-hmm. And so part of that to me is just going to be, how's that really going to feel? Because you've got, you know, the center of the square. And then these, some portions are more open than others, it feels like, as you walk around. But how much is that going to detract or really? But I like the idea of the water there. And I really like what you've done on Third. I think that the portico there and the where you've done the cutout or the courtyard to mimic, I think all that really is very attractive and really helps with the scale.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, of course, I would have loved to have seen all the iterations before you got to this.
Okay.
I have to say, Mac, my first impression was, you know, it was, I guess, the big reveal. But I think the thing that I'm concerned about, and it's hard to tell because the renderings are showing light and dark, or, you know, the color of the courthouse and then the Steve's going to try and think.
Do you have your mic on?
Oh, turn your mic on. Yeah.
Sorry. Sorry. Thank you, Steve. At any rate, I wonder if it's not competing with the courthouse. And so that's my initial reaction. And because, you know, perspectives can show, you can tilt a perspective to show a lot of things. Mm-hmm. This is from somebody who teaches designers. And so the thing that, you know, like elevations are where I really can tell, is this really going to be competing with the courthouse? But I am concerned that it may be so much like the courthouse and maybe just commanding, you know, right now it's very commanding. My first impression, this is a very commanding building. I'm not sure that I'm totally on board with that, quite frankly. Okay. The proposed retail, I feel like, is inconsistent with the rest of the building, and I think it's going to take away from the overall feel of the building, so I'm not sure I would be in favor of that. I agree with Tyler about the third story, that if there's some way to mitigate that where it's not so prominent, I think that would really help. But again, I think my first impression was it's so beautifully done. It's very commanding. And I just wonder how that's going to be in reality. Thank you. That's it.
Thank you.
I have one more, Madam Chairman, quick comment. This is just me looking at this. But all the renderings you're showing with the public square on there, you're showing it not elevated as it currently is. And I think that's throwing off your massing, because you cannot, and you go back to your original picture of what the courthouse looks now, you see how the square is elevated there. Mm-hmm. And I think that would change the whole massing of the whole scale of everything, if you would interpretate that into your renderings.
Okay, thank you.
That's all I had. Thank you.
Do you look across the street at the other buildings in the square?
Oh, yeah. We looked at that, the cornice lines, and that cornice line that I mentioned at Main Street. Mm-hmm. We intentionally aligned that one just to pull that datum, since it was on this quadrant, these two quadrants of the square. We intentionally didn't put the stone up on the third floor in fear of thinking it's going to overwhelm the courthouse. So all of our moves were intentionally done to not overwhelm the courthouse, because we don't feel it should either. But we also need to balance that with the civic presence of this building. Right. So it's a delicate balance, that it's going to take a lot of work to get there. But just know that we're not trying to overpower the courthouse. We're trying to make moves that maintain the importance of this building without diminishing the historic courthouse.
My comment would be, the portico on the square with columns that long, it feels like a nod back to the 80s when there were so many tall, unbroken columns. People are tearing them off of the fronts of houses now and breaking them up. So I would like to see a break. I don't know if it works for a porch to come. I don't know what the solution is, but a break.
Okay.
There. I think that's all you're going to see when you get on the square. Is I'm kind of reminded of what they did at Franklin High School.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be one of my comments. The other is, the Third Avenue portico is not a door. Is that right?
Correct. It's yeah. shading for the boardroom
window.
So
I don't see why on that side you wouldn't really want to calm it down. You're transitioning into residential mm-hmm. office, one office residential, and then residential, and then the courthouse addition. So I don't really know what the solution is, but just from a message point of view for the building, it'd be nice if somehow it could be, in my mind, a bench area or something.
It is. Yeah. It's that raised plaza.
Yeah. And then mm-hmm. just, bring it down. I thought some of the other people's comments were really good, too, about where does the cornice go. I feel like, personally, just as a message, I feel like that the porch up as high as you've got it on the building is awkward. Looks like the king of the village is going to come out but I think I would want to see it lower so it was more relatable.
Yes.
So I like the materials. I like the way I'm not quite as afraid of the massing as I thought I would be. So
okay, that's
I'm pleased about that. And I agree totally with Scott's comment. I think y'all are doing yourselves an injustice by not coloring in the other buildings to show their weight, just from citizens and elected officials and committees.
Okay.
Thank you. Does anybody else?
That has raised one more question for
go
me.
Ahead.
Mm-hmm. Since we're talking, did I jump
go
in front
for
of
it.
You?
Sorry.
No, go ahead.
The Third Avenue. I'm looking at your site plan right now. So when you show the benches and where I call it a portico indenting in on the Third Avenue side.
Mm-hmm.
Well, those have. Is that going to be open to the sky?
Yes.
With green space.
Yeah, but it also has a bridge across it, actually, at the second floor that's recessed back that connects this portion of the second floor to this portion of the second floor. So there'll be like a...
No, I'm talking in the main part of the city hall, the big massing.
Oh, this right here? You're just seeing the rooftop of that portico.
Okay.
So below it would be benches and seating on the raised mm-hmm. plaza.
So we'll have doors. I just won't go to the interior of the building.
No, actually, it's just raised windows into the boardroom. Because this is, this will face southwest. We don't want the light. We have double height windows in the boardroom, so we're trying to provide some kind of shading mechanism for those boardroom windows as well.
So you can access this area from the interior to go outside and sit, or...?
You won't be exiting straight from the boardroom out here. You'll just be on Third Avenue. It's like an area of respite. If you're going down Third Avenue and it's raining, you could go under there and sit. Or you don't go in the building, in the boardroom, or exit the boardroom.
It's really just breaking up the facade.
Right.
Correct.
Yeah. It's a porch that bumps out, but it's not enclosed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, and there's no entrance there.
So in the rendering.
I think that would work.
I don't know why this isn't working.
I think that is a good comment. It does break up the facade.
It does.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's covered.
Yeah.
I just think making it as important looking as the front is confusing.
Okay. I would like to go back on the Third Avenue side where we have the two-story part past the courtyard. And then you have the stone cornice. And so on top, is that just a parapet?
Yes, it's a brick parapet.
It is a brick parapet.
Mm-hmm.
So on the front, let's go talk about the front again and that stone cornice.
Mm-hmm.
At the very top, what kind of decorative detail would that be in brick currently is proposed?
At the corbelling detail, we just haven't gotten that far. We'll do some type of decorative brick corbelling there. But again, we didn't want to put stone there. Because we're trying to keep the main datum line lower as to not compete with the courthouse is what we were aiming for.
In the stone cornice that's at the top of the second story, mm-hmm. on the courthouse side, and of course on Third Avenue too, there's another frieze. You know, you see the cornice, and then below that, I think there may be one frieze, and then a second frieze that kind of lines up with the portico.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wondering if that may have to be stylistically like that to look well with that portico, but if that could be somehow diminished, it may keep that from looking so heavy.
Okay.
As far as dividing that space, and just mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know. This may be the best, but and you know, across the square, at least where the old courthouse was, and what's next to the public square building, they have like a dental work.
Mm-hmm.
And their brick at the top
right.
that forms their cornice.
Mm-hmm.
So that might be a thing could be done here too.
Yes.
I was going to talk a little about that, kind of the rest of the elevation that's not portico, just kind of the body of the building. Trying to figure out which elevation I'm looking at here.
Third.
The square looking at the front of the building with the cutaway of the building in front of it.
Mm-hmm.
That top elevation there. I think I had mentioned this before, just in a building this scale, having those repeatable elements just over and over. You've got a rhythm set up where you've got kind of bays with the pilasters.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it would help just stylistically that side and the other one if the other one's doesn't have as much repetitive because it's got the portico in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
But if that center section had some disinuating detail, most of the precedent buildings that you showed have an A section, a B section, another A,
mm-hmm.
might have a C, which is a portico, and this has a A, an A, an A, and a portico, and the other side has a B, a portico, a B, which I think works on that side, but I think it could help because it might free you up to do something different with fenestration,
mm-hmm.
might free you up to do something different material wise. To some of the other commissioners' point, the columns, I don't know that they feel that long. I too would love to see them round. Don't have a huge preference on that, but if they were round, you start to get the tapering, and there's, you know, a few thousand years precedence on how tall and fat columns are supposed
yes.
to be. It's something where you can just look up in a book, really.
Right.
And those are not off by any stretch of the imagination. A lot of civic buildings end up with some type of plinth mm-hmm. underneath the columns.
Right. It's usually in thirds.
And you can do that to lower the height of the columns, but you sacrifice something mm-hmm. in kind of a bulging thing at the bottom.
Yes.
It can become constricting, which sometimes you want, sometimes you don't. So I don't have a lot of problem there. To Brian's point, that double frieze, we don't always see that. It's really, you've got this lowest part of the frieze on the body of the building aligning with that porch rack.
Mm-hmm.
It might help to not have that one. Let the porch rack sit mm-hmm. low intentionally, because it can make just perception-wise, make the portico look shorter, even though it's
that
the exact
be.
Same height.
Mm-hmm.
It'll make the building feel like mm-hmm. just a teeny bit taller. I've seen people use cut limestone on that third floor, and it feel lighter, and everybody thinks it's rock. It can't be lighter. I'm like, we're not talking about weight, right?
Mm-hmm.
Some material that could feel like it vanishes a little bit, and mm-hmm. oftentimes like cut Indiana or something, in a very simple lay, nothing frou-frou, you can really kind of take a back seat, even though it's a heavy, permanent civic material. We see it a lot on bases of buildings too, so a lot of people go, well, wouldn't that be at the bottom? I've seen it done well on a third story if it's tastefully done. And I'm not sure the pilasters from the first floor in that elevation have to directly translate to the top floor.
Mm-hmm.
Those could be done differently. The pilasters could fatten up there. They could go away. I think all those things will help break it up a little bit, free you guys up mm-hmm. on some fenestration so that it doesn't feel so copycat to anything on the square or itself.
Mm-hmm. So. Thank you.
Can I say one more thing, Madam Chair? I think hearing all this, one thing that I would point out, I do feel like when you, especially the angle of looking where you can see what's on Public Square and on Third, I do think that the present configuration makes me think Third is the front of the building. And I know this is a weird one because it just is, but when I look at that, even in that view, I feel like Third is the front. And I do, kind of hearing all the comments, wonder if people will be confused by that. Okay. Like I'm trying to get in, but it's
for a
glass
a
wall.
And there's no door.
It's really beautiful. Like that's my favorite view. And I understand you have less road frontage on the Public Square side. Yeah. So that's harder.
Mm-hmm. And we're trying to break up the massing on that elevation. So trying to find an appropriate way to do that.
Very attractive. But I could, from a big picture standpoint, I do think that reads, I'm the front of the building.
How deep is that? I mean, you may not know, but when you go in the lobby doors there, how deep is it?
In the lobby or the portico?
Yeah, I mean, is it
go all
the way through that first bay? So not quite all the way through the first bay there. Looking down Third, you've got a set of three windows. It's not that whole section.
No.
Part of it. Okay. I was just wondering if at the risk of becoming, you know, the Jefferson Memorial, if that portico slid down and there was,
it was
two
a corner
inches in
element.
Corner,
yeah, that.
That doesn't sound like
that was
the
actually one of my studies.
Even worse.
That didn't work.
Yeah. Okay. Never mind.
So you said the upper windows in the portico are the same size as the courthouse.
The upper. So in the second, the ones at the.
Under the portico.
Yeah, I think there are 20 here. Lights. I believe that's right. And I know this is probably hard to see, but this is what the original courthouse windows look like.
Okay.
Can you share that? Mm-hmm.
Which they're beautiful. I would just hate to put that vertical bar right in the center of the window to see how, I mean, just for from a daylight and a views perspective and an experience from the inside.
I was just thinking, you know, having 20 lights there, that's a lot of lights.
Yeah, yeah, we can look at different proportions.
And it kind of reminds me of even, you know, like the glass blocks. When I see it in here, I'm just thinking
yeah, that's
glass
more
blocks.
The rendering, yeah.
Well, I'll just take one more stab at my thought about the portico on the square. I've always been taught, and if you look at all the other buildings in the perspective, that the human scale on entrances matters. Mm-hmm. And I don't think that meets that.
Okay.
And you're referring in the height of the columns.
I'm referring to the way the windows are. They read as one big element. And if you look over here on the other building, you have a human scale as you walk in. You have a human scale as you walk in the courthouse. Mm-hmm. You have a human scale as you walk in every building downtown. So that would be a break from being a human scale entrance that you see over and over downtown, which I think is going to make all your attention go to that. We've got one quadrant of the square that is basically all infill. So to me, to keep the entrance, if you look at the courthouse, the columns are broken with two doors.
Well, on the balcony,
you will not find a building. I think an elevation like on the post office downtown, they do have the levels of windows, but they've still, that bottom reads separate. And I don't really know how to say to do that, but I know you know. And I hope you
we'll
understand.
Give it a try.
I hope you understand what I'm communicating. Because I think we want this to feel like a big success as an infill project. And that I know we worked so hard when we did Streetscape to not do any of things that were kind of fads at the time. I think, you know, except for some modifications of just little extra things that have been put on since then, the basic streetscape just reads as it could have always been there. Mm-hmm. And I don't want this building, it's not going to feel like it's always been there. And the building next door doesn't feel like it's always been there. But that building next door is very popular with the residents of Franklin.
That's good.
Very, very popular. And the entrances are very human scale. So that's my last stab. We've got a few more minutes. Yes.
I just want to tag on to what you said, Mary. And I think this, my first impression was it has this sense of monumentality. And I think somehow if we can bring that where it's not so monumental. And I think that's, you know, Mary was saying that in other ways, mm-hmm. but I think that's what I get. And it competing with the courthouse and the whole square. And again, this is, I mean, it's hard because you want it to look like a city hall, to feel like mm-hmm. a city hall, but you also don't want it to compete with the other buildings. And you want it to like, oh, look at other city hall. And then you just lose everything else. Mm-hmm. So that's my yeah. closing remark.
And I'd like to make one more closing remark. Ms. Besser, you said that it will attract your eye, no question. My point earlier is that I think a big part of that is the ceremonial terrace that faces the public square. And just so we give some clear guidance for the applicant, I'd love to know, I know a few of you did mention either a porch rack or a ceremonial terrace, but just to provide a little bit more clear guidance, I thought we could spend a little more time talking about that particular feature.
Well, I think that we can address that, Ms. Marquardt, by talking about the cornice line a little bit. I think that kind of gets at some of the things that we're hearing. So I have heard from a couple of folks that the cornice rack at above the second floor is a little heavy, and we may need to tone that down mm-hmm. and perhaps introduce something a little different on the top floor. Mm-hmm. And that may help with some of that monumentality that some of you have referenced. I also heard loud and clear about the human scale. I think that's a great point. I think that what you see on the courthouse is, you know, a balcony built in, so it, mm-hmm. it breaks your eye, and it's not a bay of windows. It almost looks like a wall of windows, and we've heard you, and I think that we can do something to really address that. I had wondered if we could talk about the fenestration material a little bit. Do you envision this being a metal window or a wood window? And that can make a big difference in how it is perceived as well. So for reference, he's next door.
About windows like the public square, 231 public square, that have the ionized frame.
Yes. Versus the courthouse that yeah. has the heavy wood windows.
Yeah, and those are pre-finished aluminum frames on 231. Yeah, we did that one.
So any thoughts on that? I mean, that could help with some of the concerns you've raised.
It would be remiss of me not to say wood.
Yeah. We don't have Brad Wilson, the maintenance facilities director in here and having to maintain those.
The metal frames will give it more of a modern look. No matter mm-hmm. how you do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what I'd say is, yeah, if there's a, I think the same reason that we ask homeowners to use a historic profile of some sort mm-hmm. that we're familiar with that feels right is the way to go. You know, if that's an all wood window, that's great. Obviously, they make aluminum clad, which we're not mm-hmm. going to have to worry about for 20 years, 30 years, which is mm-hmm. a better thing than having to paint every 5 years or something.
And there are also window types that aren't aluminum clad that are some sort of a composite material that we do permit for infill yeah. products mm-hmm. that are of the appearance of mm-hmm. wood and have the historic yeah. profile and dimension, mm-hmm. but are not aluminum or wood.
I think what you'll find, though, is some of these sizes of windows, most of the aluminum clad wood manufacturers are going to go, We can't mm-hmm. do something that big. So there may be, I forget the company that's making windows for the folks at the factory.
And Peerless made the ones for 231. Okay. They can go large format.
Yeah, I can do. Yeah. So there's, you know, what I'd say is some historic profiles that are, you know, authentically replicate the sticking and the view lines and mountain bars and mullions and all that stuff from what we would perceive as the historic district. You'd want to see something like that. How you get there is...
And this may very well transition from the 231 building to the courthouse in being a more modern building to a transitional building to a classic building. Mm-hmm. There may be some merit to having more modern style windows with a classical architectural style, but it's hard for me to imagine without seeing something drawn together.
I don't think they all have to be the same.
No.
I see that glassy bridge that's the hyphen. That could be something almost like a curtain wall system. It's decidedly glass and different, whereas the fenestration there on the square might need to feel that it's bridging between contemporary and the courthouse. Mm-hmm. So it may be something in between.
A good example is page 7. So page 7 of the presentation, where it shows, I believe it's 203 Public Square, if I've got that number correct. And you look at the fenestration pattern, it kind of looks like dark holes. You know, really, they're square openings. You can't really see, you know, fenestration patterns as far as mullions, muntins. And I do agree, if something can be done where you see those, I think the building will read better.
The other thing that's just a comment. The city hall that was originally built has city hall in it. And I think it would be wonderful to do something like that in the date of the building. And we see that all over town. Just to show the pride.
We have it in that freeze that we're
going to
diminish.
Okay, yeah. I just think, you know, we want to have a lot of pride in this building. It's a long time coming.
Well, you have two porticos.
Right.
But we don't want to put it on the third avenue.
No.
It will get really confusing.
Right.
And to be clear, I don't think anybody was saying diminish that porch rack. Mm-hmm. We're saying the freeze that aligns with it that's on the building. Mm-hmm. The porch rack needs to be there because it returns in behind to your ceiling. Mm-hmm. So I think you still got your space for your lettering. It's the rest of it that seems a little.
So to Ms. Markart's question about the balcony, here's my question. Is it a ceremonial balcony for within the balcony or to public square? Because if it is to be ceremonial out into public square, I do think being that tall is pretty tall. If you're going to have a ceremony on the balcony, I don't think it matters where it lands on the building. If it's designed
to... Yeah, it's more of a, not to perform ceremonies, but just it's third floor access to overlook the square.
Okay.
And it's aligned with the third floor. So really, we have two options, right? We can align it with second floor.
Yep, yep.
And I'm a second floor fan. Yeah.
We don't have a floor in here, but...
yeah. but, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's helpful to me.
But the balconies don't have to happen. That's just something we're exploring. Mm-hmm. And, we've talked about... Mm-hmm. Originally, we thought, no, not a roof terrace overlooking the square. That's too distracting. It's just not appropriate. And then we reduced them to be on top of these porticos as third floor access. Mm-hmm. Since we have double height space in the boardroom and in the lobby and no floor at second level. So.
Well, I personally, if they're up there, and I guess we've got 1-2 minutes left, I'm fine with that. I just think Tyler's idea that it be round columns and they be tapered, or I personally believe the building is going to be better if there is a break in those columns, and if you repeat the entrances that you see on every building, the scale of it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you all so very much. This has been really, really helpful.
Mm-hmm. And we'll just need about 5 minutes in between meetings just to announce to the public who's watching.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll be back at 405. Thank you all.